And you felt, did you feel pain?
I did. And when, there was so much adrenaline also, I think.
Okay. And when she hit you over the head with a bottle, did you feel pain then?
Yes.
Okay. And then when in this kind of sequence of events was she trying to choke you?
Before, throughout really the whole time, she was trying to choke me.
Okay. And at some point did you pass out?
I did. After she broke the bottle over my head and stabbed me, and she was trying to choke me, I remember thinking of Aurora and feeling like I just thought of her and I felt like I wanted to survive also for her. And so I fought back harder, and I remember she got up, she was straddling me before, and she went further up, and I actually pinned down my arms with her knees.
Can I approach one?
Yeah.
And she pinned down my arms with her legs.
Okay.
And actually used, I remember she was trying so hard to choke me, and then when she got closer, she just bore down with her whole weight on the heel of her hand over my windpipe, and I just remember everything going black.
Okay. Now, did you ever see the defendant with a knife?
I didn't.
Okay. After you went, everything went black. Tell the jury what you remember next.
So, I woke up on the floor of the room, and I remember my first instinct was to get up, and I just felt this really intense pain in my stomach.
And Ms. Wilkins, do you know how long you had been passed out?
No.
All right, so you woke up, you're on the floor, you weren't on a bed. Okay.
And I tried to move. And I just felt this really intense pain in my stomach. And I looked down and, you know, I just saw this really big cut across my stomach. And I pulled my pants for, you know, high-waisted pregnancy pants. So I pulled them up and I started looking around the room. Things started coming back about, you know, how she had attacked me. So, you know, I kind of started thinking, maybe she's still in the house, should I go? I can't outrun her, you know, if I'm in so much pain, I can't outrun her if I go through the front door. And there was a window, and I was kind of putting together an escape plan in my head, you know, should I climb out the window or make a run for it? Or, and the first thing I thought I would do was just block the door, and so I just stood up. And my feet couldn't support me, so I just fell forward and on top of my hand. And when I did that, I just felt the blood seeping through my pants. And I could feel my intestines outside of my body.
Okay.
And so I could...
Fair to say you didn't think you could climb out the window?
Yes.
Okay. Did you try to shut the door?
I willed myself to stand and stumble towards the door. And, you know, my vision felt really blurry, so I feel like, you know, I like closed the lock or put the lock. And when I turned around next to the bed, were still both of our cell phones. I guess it was hers. I saw mine and another cell phone. And so I just stumbled back to the bed and laid down on my back and picked up my phone.
Okay, so you picked up your phone to call 911?
Yes.
And were you able to call 911?
I was.
Okay. Now, did you put your code into your phone?
No, it's like I kept trying to put my code in, and my fingers were fumbling, and so it accidentally swiped onto the emergency screen, so I ended up just making the call from there.
Okay. And Somebody answered at 911.
Yes.
And you were on the phone for a while?
I was, yes.
Were you able to give him the address?
Yes.
And then what happened?
So, I don't really remember much of the conversation. Only that, you know, I was talking for the whole duration, and they kept saying, I kept asking for help. Because, you know, just staying present was really difficult at the time. And so they kept saying that help was going, they were on their way. And eventually I actually heard the cops knock on the door, and I told her that they were there, that the police were there.
Okay.